Let's revisit this flat car. As you may remember from earlier videos, this is a cheap shake the box Athearn flat car kit from many, many years ago that I've so far thrown it together, painted it, but now let's make it run well. It came, like so many of them back in that era did, with horn hook couplers on them, which are kind of nasty. They don't look anything like an actual coupler. They work, I mean, but among the things that happens when you hook them together, they push the car quite a bit sideways. They're supposed to be able to automatically uncouple with an under the track thing, which came with all the cheesiest train sets back in the day. But those trip pin things on the back tended to get snagged and broken off, and they just don't look right. So they go into a bin with a whole bunch of other scrap plastic that never gets used again. But we have these coupler boxes on the bottom here. Oops. Left over from them, which we might be able to use. Let me get out of there. So we might be able to use those for a coupler. Now then, the gold standard forever has been the KD number 5. Way back, I bought a multi-pack of them, like a 20 or something pack. So I've got all these coupler boxes that I haven't used because I often end up using the one that's on the car, and only a very few couplers left. So I might use them, but I'm going to try something else first, and if it works, great. These are a less expensive copy. That sale price is obviously, it was on a cheap sale when I bought them, and I bought them, as everything else around here, decades ago. I've got two different types. I've got overshank and undershank, and you can just about see where the shank or shaft goes in. It meets at the bottom of the coupler on this undershank one, and at the top of the coupler on this overshank one. You could also get centered shank ones. And the standard KD number 5 is a centered shank. You can also get KD couplers with overshank and undershank and a whole bunch of other variants, longer shank and shorter and different things. But I'm going to try this with the Bachmanns just to see if I can, if the height is right. If not, I'll try the KDs, and if nothing works with this coupler box, then I'll have to go all heavy duty and do some surgery on that, but I don't want to if I can avoid it. So, first step, I don't even know why I took that off. Get this out of the way. Pull my coupler test gauge up here. And I'm just going to set this on there and just get a bit of an eyeball on it. So, where's my KD again? And this is going to get really hard to see if I get my big mitts in there. So I'm going to avoid doing that. So, to get the shank, to get the couplers, I mean, to meet up. That's going to be, get in there. That actually sits fairly close to the top of there. Just grab this better. There. So that's actually going to be, very close to the middle of that coupler box. Actually, I think the centered shank is probably going to be the better option. Okay, put those back in the accumulation for another day. So, there's one of those. Get another one out of there. There's a couple of those. Now again, I'm not sure how well they're going to work with these coupler boxes, but we'll... Where'd the screw go? We'll give it a shot. Actually, that sits on the pin fairly nicely. And then I'll get a better pair of tweezers here. So this is the KD coupler spring on the Bachmans and actually on the Hornhooks too. Notice they have these little plastic fingers to act as a centering spring. And the Hornhook is this little thingy. KD's system uses a little metal spring, which disappointingly... Oh, will it fit down in there? That does fit down in there. Nice. This is going to be even easier than I thought. And the coupler on top of there, and then these little spring clip units. That explains why I have so many of these KD coupler boxes left over. Actually, did I? Yeah, I think you saw earlier. There's how they assemble. I've just got a bolt to hold it together, but there's the centering spring in action. Okay. So, let me grab a little pair of pliers from back here. And just, so that's not quite square. I'm just going to bend those sides in so they grip a little bit tighter on the side of the coupler box. And then, yeah, so there's the biggest challenge with doing this job, actually, getting all the pieces to stay together while you get your meat hooks in there. And try and snap that lid on. Now, did I squeeze that too tight? I'll do something about the lighting in here. And I did say I was going to, didn't I? You think I'm gonna... Oh, yeah. I'm gonna open that back up a little bit. I got too carried away on it. So, the N scale guys always keep saying, oh, you should move to N scale. You'll have so much more room and a bigger layout. But then I get into doing this and I think, nah, that's a bad plan. Oh, there we go. Almost get down there, you. Did I put that on backwards? Let's fight it down. That's that side down. And that's that side snap down. Is it really on there? Seems to be. Okay. I'll put the truck back on. Just roughly. Get on. Yes, I know I'm doing it upside down. Okay. So what happens here? All this screwing around just because I'm too lazy to take my camera off its stand, but oh, that's the perfect height. That's excellent. Okay. So now I'm just going to repeat that for the other end of the car. But I don't think you need to suffer through that. Okay, I'm back. There's the other coupler on. And as you can see, the height is damn near perfect. But the trip pin's following on that little lip on the bottom of the coupler gauge there. See that? The whole point of that lip is to provide a gauge for your trip pin height. So I'm going to just give the trip pin a very slight little bend up here, which is not the easiest thing to do with the wrong tool. And of course, I think I mentioned earlier in another video, Katie does make a tool for this job, which, like everything, shit. Okay. And that tool, like everything in model railroading, is expensive. So, now that that's off there, I'm going to figure out how to do that one of these days. I'm going to use these other pliers. Cost is the real reason why I don't have the KD trip pin tool. And if you got the budget, sure, why not? I don't. So now then, that's one thing that I don't like. Well, I mentioned it before on these cheap kits. I'm not a big fan of how the couplers go together, the coupler boxes. That thing splayed out a little bit. This is the second one I put on, so I didn't quite get it right. Bend those in just a hair. That's reasonable. And back to fighting with this guy again. If this was a better or a model that I wanted to do to a higher standard, I would have drilled this out, but that's a complete pain. Would have drilled it and screwed it, which is why KD makes these with the hole in the coupler box for that bolt. And there, that's more solid. I think it's sitting a little higher too. Let's try that. You're tired of watching me put these trucks on and off and on and off and on and off. Yeah, it's still not, it's not a hard task, it's just time consuming. So I didn't quite get that bent up as much as I had hoped for. Let's see if I can find a better pair of pliers. These ones don't have any grip on the, and those ones are kind of worn off. I'm gonna find another pair. Doesn't take much. Well, there we go, that's clearing now. And that's so close, that's within a whisker of the right height. Okay, so there's the couplers on it. Now the other thing that I like to do just to make them run a little bit better, swap the wheels out. I've got some metal wheels on Delrin shafts here. These particular ones are Proto 2000, before Proto 2000 got bought from Lifelike. And I'm not quite sure. I've got two different sizes, 33 and 36 scale inches. So I'll just pop these guys off, and all I'm doing is just gently bending the side frame out, just ever so gently. And I'm only using the screwdriver because my hands are big. So these original ones, they're not bad looking, but I still prefer the metal wheels because the metal wheels give you a little bit more weight down at the bottom. They don't abrade off onto the track and leave goo behind. Well, not goo, but bits of plastic. So these ones are pretty much an exact fit for the 33-inch wheels. It's just barely fits in there. So that's the ones that I'm going to use, is the 33-inch flat back wheels. And get out of there. So here's the original ones. I'm just going to zoom way back in again here. So the difference between them, these ones, the plastic runs on the rails and has a metal shaft. These ones, the metal runs on the metal rails and has a plastic shaft. The plastic shaft has just a little bit of a narrowing in the center, kind of like real wheels do. And zoom in even tighter onto the wheel faces. It's got lettering. Isn't that awesome? Again, it's nothing that you're going to notice while the thing's moving, but it just looks cool. So, same thing again. Poke one end in, spread the side frame apart ever so slightly, and pop it in. Get in there. I know you can't see what I'm doing, but there we go. Nice smooth running. So now we've got Delrin axles, slippery engineering plastic, running against Delrin side frames, slippery engineering plastic, and boy, do they slip along. See if I can do that. So there, just pull that out. I'm not pulling all that hard. If I can, intentionally trying not to, because I don't want to break anything. Guys in there. Get in. Oh, he got in when I wasn't looking. Well, those just roll forever. Okay. So since they were just a hair different size, like ridiculously tiny amount, I just want to make sure that my coupler heights aren't messed up. And they're not. That's excellent on that end. Let's look at this end. That works there too. Cool. So there we go. That was just a quick little upgrade that you can do on any train set car. These basic blue box Atherns, they've been the standard forever for a cheap first kit, and I encourage you to try them out. Now then, sometime in the future, I've got a couple more things I want to do to this particular car. When I get around to it, I'll be deckling it and then weathering it. But now that it's summer, I'm not quite sure when that's going to happen. I assume it'll probably be a rainy day.